Welcome to Space News from the Electric Universe, brought to you by the Thunderbolts Project at thunderbolts.info. A groundbreaking new scientific report provides dramatic confirmation of our planet's dynamic electrical environment and the Earth-Sun connection. Phys.org recently reported that the European Space Agency's Swarm mission has discovered, quote, supersonic plasma jets high up in our atmosphere that can push temperatures up to almost 10,000 degrees Celsius. Attempting to provide historical context for the discovery, the report states, the theory that there are huge electric currents powered by solar wind and guided through the ionosphere by Earth's magnetic field was postulated more than a century ago by Norwegian scientist Kristian Birkeland. While much is known about these current systems, recent observations have revealed that they are associated with large electrical fields. In fact, in recent years, the term Birkeland current has appeared with increasing regularity in mainstream scientific literature. Today, Professor Donald Scott discusses his own original modeling of a Birkeland current structure, and he explores the significance of this new discovery from the Electric Universe perspective.
Swarm is a constellation of three satellites designed to look at the geomagnetic field of Earth. They wanted to put some decent sensors, better sensors than had ever been flown before, I guess, up and to investigate what exactly the properties of the Earth's geomagnetic field were. It's encouraging that this recent article about Swarm not only mentions the phrase Birkeland current several times, but it also talks about electric fields. Now, that's a word that almost never gets mentioned in the establishment literature, but it's getting to be fairly well known that electrical energy does indeed come from the sun to Earth in large tube-like conduits that have, over the years, become known as Birkeland currents. The establishment usually only talks about magnetic and gravitational fields, but the all-important term electric current usually has been missing. This latest Swarm article makes it appear that the establishment may have been quietly listening to our ideas. Now, of course, they're never going to give us credit for it. They will now claim that they discovered everything, and they will try to ignore the existence of our prior claims. But I think it's our duty to ourselves and actually to posterity to stake out those claims and say exactly what we have said in the past about things like Birkeland currents. I will say that my model, which I hasten to say is an extension of the work of some other folks such as Hannes Alfvén, who won the Nobel Prize in Physics, and Anthony Peratt, and a fellow by the name of Stig Lundquist, who actually started the work on this model back in 1950. That model predicts most, if not all, of what the Swarm release refers to as their discoveries. It makes me a little bit worried about whether they have ever heard of some of the people. Certainly they have never heard of me, but you think they might have heard of Hannes Alfvén and Tony Peratt and, of course, Kristian Birkeland. But anyway, in 2015, the scientific journal Progress in Physics published an article of mine in which I included a quantitative derivation of this model. I finished it off. Well, Lindquist started it, and I ended up developing the equations that describe the physical structure of a Birkeland current. Those equations must be interpreted to follow up on what those equations predict about what the model must look like. Lundquist, in spite of my giving him credit for coming up with some of those equations, he never, like I guess most mathematicians don't, interpreted what those equations predicted for what the Birkeland current would look like and how it would act. But the model, as I developed it, shows the presence of electrical currents that flow in spiral paths in opposite directions. Those things were in that Swarm article. Oppositely directed currents, yes. And the Birkeland current itself is made up of a set of, and this is, I think, the important point, the Birkeland current is a set of concentric, counter-rotating cylinders of electrical current and magnetic fields. And the currents and the fields are at all points in those Birkeland currents parallel. They're aligned. When you align the currents with the magnetic fields, the internal stresses on the Birkeland current relax and go to zero. And that's the single property that makes those Birkeland currents able to go over tremendous distances. I mean, we know they go from the sun to the Earth, and that's 93 million miles. Well, that's nothing. That's a child's footstep compared to the astronomical distances in light years some of these so-called jets from galaxies extend over. And those currents don't come apart. They don't spread out like a garden hose will end up in a bunch of droplets sprinkling over your lawn. They hang right together in collinear alignment, and that's the reason they do. The formal name for a Birkeland current really is a field-aligned current. It's a force-free current because the fields are aligned. Anyhow, the Swarm article says, each satellite has an electric field instrument positioned at the front to measure plasma density, drift, and velocity. Well, if that's indeed the truth, then I would think they should have measured some kind of concentric counter-rotation, because the counter-rotation is the prime property, as far as I'm concerned, of the Birkeland current. But either they haven't observed it, or if they did observe it, they have neglected to mention it, maybe because they don't know why it occurs. It's well known that the Earth has a geomagnetic field. It's less well known, but it's equally true that the Earth and many of the planets also have their own electric field. And the electric field that emanates either to or from Earth is a very powerful electric field. The Earth is, and most of the planets, I think, are also electrically charged. Yeah, if you sit down and analyze what that phrase means, supersonic plasma jets. Plasma is a word that defines a cloud-like collection of charges, you know, plus ions, negative electrons, all going along or traveling along in a cloud-like formation. And a jet is a moving stream. It's a flow. So a flow of charge, well, that's the definition of an electric current. But we already knew this. That's what Birkeland himself, back in the early 1900s, said was going on. That's what they laughed at him for saying.
For continuous updates on space news from the electric universe, stay tuned to thunderbolts.info.